Hi everyone, welcome to Mrs. Johnson's Black History Music Lesson. This lesson is for fourth grade classes and our lesson is called Sign and Song, Part 1. We have learned about the Civil Rights Movement and its fight for equal rights. One of those battles was fighting for the right to attend better schools. Schools were segregated back then. Students of color had smaller schools that had little money to keep up with repairs. They also had less supplies for their students, like books, papers, pencils, and even desks to sit at. While white-only schools had more money to build larger, nicer schools, and they can buy plenty of school supplies to support their students. But what you didn't know was that the schools for the deaf and blind were also segregated. As you can guess, white-only schools had knowledgeable teachers with lots of resources to help educate their blind and deaf students. Colored schools for the deaf and blind had another set of challenges. Besides not having the supplies that they needed, a lot of teachers at the colored schools didn't know how to communicate with the deaf students. Some deaf students were expected to learn how to read lips, even though they had no idea what their teacher was saying. May 17, 1954 marked a major change. The Brown v. Board of Education case was won, giving students the right to integrate and attend the best schools together. Over the next 20 years, deaf and blind students began to attend better schools to properly learn ASL, or the American Sign Language. ASL is the standard way to teach deaf people how to talk with their hands. You might be wondering, what did deaf people of color do to communicate before they were able to properly learn American Sign Language? Well, the answer is simple. They use BASL. Or Black American Sign Language. It's a combination of regular ASL with some different signs and expressions mixed in. Each region of the U.S. got its own version because it matches the unique language of the locals. It was passed on person to person. Allow me to introduce Nakia Smith. She is a deaf TikToker who is sharing BASL with everyone all around the world. Here's her story. Nakia will not speak during this video. Remember, her hands is her voice. I will help everyone out by reading what she signs. The biggest difference between BASL and ASL is that BASL got seasoning. Honestly, BASL is different from ASL. With BASL, we will sign with both hands. And ASL is more like one hand. For example, in ASL, we will sign, "You're in my business, don't do that." In BASL, we will sign, "Stop being nosy, mind your business." There are differences in individual words as well. Like in ASL, "This is Christmas." In BASL, "This is Christmas." Curious and curious. Hurt and hurt. Children and children. I felt like a lot of people didn't know about BASL until my video went viral. They were really curious and wanted to learn more about BASL and history. I told my grandfather that the video went viral and he said, "Really? Keep it going." My favorite comment I saw was, "Can we preserve this language too?" And I thought, the same. We can. For Black History Month this year, we are going to use Black American Sign Language to perform one of the greatest songs of all time, "Lean On Me," written by Bill Withers. Bill Withers was a music icon who wrote and performed beautiful music from his heart. Withers explained in a quote, "I write and sing about whatever I am able to understand and feel." It is his clear messages and memorable melodies that continues to reach audiences of all ages. Let's listen.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
That was great. So here we now have a group of friends who are going to share their unique styles of Black American Sign Language to a different version of the same song, Lean On Me. This time the song is performed by an 80s R&B group called Club Nouveau. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.